Thank you. Thank you. So I think I'll hurry it up a little bit, thinking about time. A lot of the discussion already has happened in the list. So I'll talk quite fast, but please stop me if you think I move over something that interests you or you want to ask a question. So I want to more or less talk about the motivation, the plumbing. Want to show how we would do this IOPF, IO page fault in user space. So I'm going to use a little bit of time for pseudocode. And at the end, I have some questions that I think have not been discussed in the lists. And whatever pops up in the discussion also, we can talk about it. So let's jump over this and go directly to the plumbing. So this QR code is the list discussion. So you can go there and see what has been discussed. Basically, what we did for the Linux kernel, very, very simple change, because the functionality, the IOPF functionality for the Intel IOMMU driver was already there. We just simply tweaked it a little bit in order to remove some restrictions from it. So we did five things. We moved a bunch of things related to the page request code from SVM, Intel SVM, into a new file called prq.c. And then we removed checks for passive when the IOMMU initializes and also in the prq messaging. We also enabled the PRI in the IOMMU HWPT alloc IOctl. So I'm going to go more or less through what we did very, very quickly again, so we maybe catch up. These are all the functions that migrated, and it was just literally a copy-paste, nothing fancy here, from svm.c to this new file, prq.c. We removed the passive present check. So every time that some PRI, PCIe message was arrived, it checked if the passive was present. And if the passive was not present, then it was not possible. So we removed that. And now it is possible to have a PRI interaction without the actual passive bit being one, being present. Here we moved, so since we moved everything from the svm.c file to the prq.c file, we also moved this into a new kconfig. So now the PRI stuff, the IOPF stuff is not dependent on the SVM, it's solely dependent on the Intel IMMU. So you don't have to have Intel SVM IMMU set, you just have to have Intel IMMU set, and then you have PRI. This is the enabling on a PRI on the IOctl. So here we in order to be able to use page requests in user space, you need to have a fault handle, and you need to pass in the IOctl, you need to pass that yes, I do have a fault handle. And this is the flag to certify that I have a fault handle. And so before, we did not check that flag. And so even if I did create the correct structure with the fault handle and with the flag, it didn't register in the kernel. So this is the change that corrects this. And now with the correct, setting up the correct IOctl and setting the correct flag, it'll just work. And finally, to initialize the IOMMU IOMMU driver, there was checks also for passive if the capability was present. And so since the passive is not strictly required to have IOPF in user space, then we just remove that. And so that's the code that went into the kernel, and that's still being discussed in the lists. Now we switch a little bit to see more or less how it's used in user space. So there's not a lot of difference there until the end of what happens in user space. It's business as usual. To set up the IMMU, you call the FIO, you call the bind, you bind the VFIO with the device, and then it's very difficult to see. I'm sorry, it's very difficult to see. But then after the bind, you attach it, and also business as usual. There's no difference in what you have originally had to do by using a VFIO. After attaching it, this is new in the sense that this had to be done in order to use IOPF in user space, but it's not new to our patch. Because without our patch, you would still have needed to do this, and it's to create the fault handle, and to have the kernel have that fault handle and hold it there, you get an ID, and then with that fault handle, then you create a IOPF capable hardware page table. And this is somewhat new. This goes through the, okay, now I prepare the octal, now I have the flag that it's valid, and I create this hardware page table. This wasn't possible before because of the check, because of the flag check. But now you pass the flags, you pass the handle, everything goes through. And then here, the last step is where you do an attach again. And then you go through the path of reattaching that hardware page table, and it gets replaced. And this hardware page, the hardware page table that gets replaced with a one that is IOPF enabled. And that's it. And then after that, you set up your little hardware page table, and you can use IOPF in user space, no problem. And how to use it. Also, this is not new at all. This was already there. It was done by Intel. And it's basically you just read the file descriptor that IMMUFD gives you to interact with this IOPF. So you get the file descriptor, you read it, you pull it, and then once you detect there is a page fault, then you solve it. And usually you solve it with a map or whatever it is that you have to do. After the map, you return it has been successful or it has not been successful, and then you know the process keeps going. And that's it. And on the outset of this, we had a lot of questions, but since we discussed it in the list, it's been mostly answered. So I'm left with two outstanding questions, and it's all this work has been done in the Intel IMMU driver, and I personally have not looked very much into AMD or ARM or RISC, and the question would be, would it make sense to do or look into the ARM or RISC or AMD drivers to enable a IOPF in user space without PASSID?
So ARM currently does not support PRI, although when we do support PRI there, I would expect this all to work. AMD supports PRI, but only for the SVA case, I think.
So and it doesn't have this Intel where it does. You can go out of the SVA case and still be supported.
No, they didn't implement that yet.
Okay.
I would like them to implement that, but it hasn't been done.
Okay.
There's no hardware reason why it can't work. It's just missing software components to set up the right.
I
hope they'll get there this year.
Okay.
I don't know.
Okay, so I guess the answer is maybe not.
I have a lot of use cases for PRI outside of SVA that are interesting, like backing KVM with a PRI, for instance, would be really interesting.
Yep.
So I'm expecting that those will motivate people to finish the work.
Yeah, but I think the hardware would have to go first, and then maybe we follow with the software, or what's your...
I mean, since AMD... It seems like your software will just work once the drivers are enabled. So
yeah, for sure. Yeah, I guess it depends what the software that the AMD driver puts forward, because there had to be changes in Intel, but I guess, yeah, it depends on what they...
Yeah, no, they'll need changes like exactly. Intel to their driver, and once they do it, then their driver will work with your user space without any user space changes. That's
yeah, I think the two details that touched IMMUFD, then it'll just work.
Yeah, those are generic. They should they should be fine.
Exactly.
And I don't know where RISC-V is on its journey.
Yeah.
It's sad.
Very long time.
And is PASSID tied with that?
Yeah, PASSID is tied with that. But I just wanted to add, RISC-V MMU does support PRI. I don't know if Evan or somebody is here for the driver side of things. Do you want to add something?
Right. Yeah, exactly, and that's the point. So the point here is that we remove the PASSID and the PRI relationship. That's the, and the question then becomes: would RISC hardware concept would it support this separation as well as Intel, for example? That's the question.
I don't know.
Okay. Okay. Yeah. Okay. And so cool. And then the other question. Somebody else has a question.
Going to ask if there's any plan to handle the faults directly in KVM to populate pages from existing mem slots.
Hey, yes. I was working on that. I can't say very much, but that's my optimism, right? I hope that we'll get there someday. You don't have to do it in KVM, actually. We'll wire it up with HMM techniques in IOMMUFD itself. It'll be neat.
In kernel with less latency than going up to user space. That's all.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, instead of doing SVA, so today we do SVA and SVA triggers handle MM fault. Instead of doing that, you turn around and do HMM range fault and then re-mirror the bumble, because you have to mirror the copy of the, yeah. Or something cool with guess memfd or memfd or whatever, I don't know.
Yeah.
Jonathan?
Anybody else? No. So, and then the other question or the other comment is something a little bit in parallel to our work, which is something that we use to actually test all this, which is a library that interacts with IOMMU and IOMMU-FD, BFIO. And I talked with Jason a little bit before, and I think I got my answer, but I'm going to ask it anyway and see if anybody else wants to have an opinion about it. And is there an interest in having an IOMMU or IOMMU-FD testing infrastructure that tests hardware or tests the code itself with QEMU or tests QEMU, the implementations of the IOMMU drivers and so on and so forth? That's the question.
Jonathan said yes.
Okay.
I also
Jonathan
thought it was
yes.
a good idea. I don't.
Yeah.
Alex is super excited.
Yeah.
look at his face.
Okay, that's all I have. Thank you very much.